Hello students, welcome back to the chapter Cleaning Organization. Myself, Paramveer Singh, Associate Professor with Chitkara School of Hospitality. Today we are going to discuss about cleaning procedures or cleaning processes, and in this topic we'll discuss about manual methods and mechanical methods. Manual methods of cleaning we have already discussed in the last video, and in today's class we'll discuss about mechanical cleaning methods. So first, what are cleaning procedures? The same slide was there in the previous video also. So cleaning processes are done with the help of mechanical and manual methods, and there are various processes like washing, friction method, suction method or force method which are used for cleaning, and there are various types of cleaning processes which are manual and mechanical methods. And in today's video we'll discuss about mechanical methods of cleaning. As I've told, manual methods of cleaning are already discussed in the previous video. Mechanical methods of cleaning or mechanized methods. These utilize equipments powered by electricity as well as mechanical gadgets. These include suction cleaning, spray buffing, polishing, burnishing, scrubbing. Okay, so let's begin. Suction cleaning. Suction cleaning is basically done with the help of vacuum cleaners. Suction, where with the power of electricity and a motor, you do the cleaning with the help of that gadget, and it sucks the dust from a particular area. This is the basic and preparatory step to all other mechanized procedures and should be performed regularly. Very often it must also be repeated at the end of these processes. The goal is to remove as much as dry soil as possible so that it does not spread, scratch the finish or damage the surface. There are chances when you are doing a dry mop or a sweeping, there are chances that you might end up leaving a small dust or dirt on the floor itself at the corners, which can be removed with the help of suction cleaning. Vacuuming with high filtration machines is the most complete method of dry soil removals, as it picks up packages and removes soil without spreading it around. Vacuum has the power to suck the dust from the ground, which you are not able to remove with the help of broom or a dry mop. Wet vacuum cleaners are now available, which help to mop up water from the floors as well. These are usually dual function machines that can be used for both wet and dry work. Extraction machines for cleaning carpets also work on the principles of suction. Extraction machines, which are used for removing water from the upholstery, which is used in dry cleaning. These extraction machines are used in dry cleaning processes also. Equipments and agents required for suction cleaning are wet or dry vacuum cleaners with attachments and a mild detergent for wet cleaning if necessary. Spray buffing is the next subtopic. This process uses a 175 to 300 RPM, that is revolutions per minute, floor machine and a soft pad or a brush. The operator sprays a light mist of a commercial cleaning preparation or detergent and a finishing solution in front of the machine. As the machine goes over the area, soil scuffs, light scratches and marks are removed and the shine is restored to the surface. Buffing is basically where, with the help of a machine, you buff these place, you rub the surface with like more rotations of the pad, which is used for the cleaning purpose, and you end up getting a shiny surface. Equipments which are required are a buffing machine with a wedge pad, which has a RPM of 175 to 300, a spray bottle, a detergent, and a finishing solution. Next is polishing. This process uses a 175 to 1500 RPM floor machine and a soft pad or a brush to remove some soil and put the shine back in the finish. Equipments which are required is a 175 to 1500 RPM floor machine and a soft pad or brush, which can be used as an abrasive. Burnishing machine or burnishing. This process uses an ultra high speed floor machine with a RPM of 1500 to 2500 to restore a deep gloss to the floor finish. Since the finish is tempered by the friction and heat produced by the burnishing machine, the floor looks better for a longer time. Vacuuming or dust mopping and damp mopping are preparatory steps and should also be used as follow-up procedures to remove loosened dirt. Before and after burnishing, you need to clean the floor on regular intervals. Once you need to do the burnishing, you clean the floor, and once the burnishing is done, you need to keep the floors clean so that the shine of that particular area is there for a longer duration. Equipments which are required is a floor machine with high RPM. Next is scrubbing. This process removes embedded dirt marks, deeper scuffs, and scratches from the floor along with some of the finish. The type of pad or brush, the type of detergent, the water temperature, and the weight and the speed of the machine all determine whether the process is considered light or heavy scrubbing. It depends upon the type of machine you are using, the type of detergent you are using, or the type of brush or the pad which are you are using for cleaning or scrubbing that particular area. For instance, aggressive pads, higher pH detergent solutions, and fast and heavy machines perform the deepest scrubbing. Scrubbing is basically done to remove the stains, you can say, or the dirt which is stuck to the floors. Light scrubbing removes just one or two coats of finish. Heavy scrubbing removes all or most of the finish down to the protective sealing coat. Equipments required for this purpose are floor maintenance machines and the pads, the round pads which are of green color. That's all for today, and in the next video we will discuss about design features that simplify cleaning. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.